And here I come. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. This is Dr. Arindam and you are watching The Teaching Doc. Yes, the venue is different. You can see the background is different. I am at my friend's place. But today we will talk about one of the most important topics of photo editing, that is a properly calibrated monitor. This is especially important for those who are willing to edit photos, who are willing to sell photos, because once you work in photo editing and once you try to sell your photos to various stock agencies, without a properly calibrated monitor, your images will be rejected right away at the review process. And the scariest fact is, most of the monitors that you buy are not calibrated at all. However, there is nothing to worry. In this video, I'll be telling you number of ways how you can calibrate your existing monitor. So stick to the end and let's learn something new. Welcome back guys, this is Dr. Arindam and if you are watching the channel for the first time, this is a channel for helping you content creators, photographers and videographers so that you can sell your content online and convert your passion of photography into some passive income. So if you are new here, consider subscribing. Now if you have been following my channel and my videos for some time, you must have noticed in the video description, as you scroll down, there is a link for monitor calibration. Now I got a lot of questions as to sir, what this link is all about, and I will definitely answer that. But first, you should know what is the importance of a calibrated monitor. Well, a properly calibrated monitor means the colors and the whites and the blacks as you see on your monitor appears exactly the same in the monitor of the reviewer, which becomes very important. That is, if your monitor is not calibrated, the colors that you see in your own monitor, the colors that you are happy with after editing the photos, will appear different in the monitor of the reviewer, and your images have got a high chance of being rejected or not being sold at all. See, professionals even invest more than $2,000 for a single monitor. However, it is not recommended, as I have already told you guys, the beginners, that you should not invest many things to start with. You should always start with what you got. So the first step in calibrating your monitor is by using your graphic card software. You can get to the options of them by just clicking right click and graphic card properties in Windows, or if you are in Mac, you need to go to display properties and assisted properties. Well, it's not possible for me to exactly show you how to use the software, because every graphic card is different and every software has got their own modes of implementation. But once you get into the menu, it is pretty straightforward. For those who are using desktop PC, you will have some buttons beside your monitor, and those buttons can really help you calibrating your display as well. But for those who are using laptops, I am afraid you are limited to your graphic card software only. Means those of you guys who are using the desktop monitor, first you need to land up to a suitable place using your graphic card software options, and then you can adjust your monitor button settings. A very important information in this regard is you need to keep your monitor in a neutral mode, alright? Not sports, not vivid, not movie, not anything, simply the neutral mode. In the standard or neutral mode, first fix the colors, and then for your own liking you can shift to other modes, but for photo editing always shift back to the neutral or standard modes. Just a small break here, construction work is going on all around here, so you'll hear different types of sounds, but I think I am clear with my content, right? So there are expensive options. You can find many videos in YouTube and other popular media as to how to use calorimeters to calibrate your monitors. Yeah, definitely those are instrument with which, those are hardware instrument with which you can calibrate your display the colors. And you can buy properly calibrated IPS screens monitor, huge size monitor, or last but not the least, you can buy this one. All Apple monitors are properly calibrated. But all these options are not affordable for many of the stock photography beginners. So in this video, I'll be taking you to a website whose link is in my video description as to how to calibrate your existing monitor.
Alright, so now we are in the website menu. It says www.lagom.nl/lcdtest.gradient.php. This is actually simple to navigate. You can just go to lagom.nl and then just open the LCD monitor calibration and testing, and you can go to this site. As I told you, please ignore a lot of construction sounds that are going around. Anyways, in this website you need to just, you don't need to go through all these detailed tools, alright, it will drive you crazy. So you just need to test five stuffs. Number one is contrast, so contrast you need to check. Next is gamma calibration, or gamma calibration as you pronounce it. Next is black level. Next is white saturation, and last but not the least, gradient bending. All right. So I'll just briefly tell you one by one what are these, so that you can easily figure out yourself. In the contrast, it says these are instructions which are given here, which is very easy to figure out. You should be able to see all of the bands, all right, all of these color bands you need should be able to see on your monitor. If not, then you need to adjust your monitor settings using the graphic card or the hardware buttons, all right. But you should be able to see all of them. If not, then your monitor is not properly calibrated. I can see all of these colors in my monitor. I don't know the output of the YouTube video whether you'll be able to see all the colors or not, but trust me, I can see all of them. So you should be able to see all of them as well. If not all of them are visible, if this area is appearing too much dark or this area is appearing too much lighter and all the bands are smeared, then it is not correct, all right. So first correct the contrast. The next test is the gamma calibration. In gamma calibration, what you need to do is, as the test says, you first read it what it says, and then you should actually, for this test, you need to take a few steps back so that you are able to see all these colors and all these bands are not visible. Alright, if you zoom very closely, you can see there are multiple small bands which are visible, but at if you take a few step back, then it should be completely invisible, and you should go ahead as these instructions says. And note down one thing: these tests are actually very sensitive and your eyes must also need some rest. So if you are tiring out, just close your eyes or look at some dark place and then again switch your vision back. And also it is very important to have a neutral light, because the neutral light in your room, because the ambient light also have some influence on the color toning. So next, after the gamma calibration, we'll go to black levels. In the black levels, there are few squares, alright, there are few black squares which are in the black background, and ideally you should be able to see all of them. The brightest one is the white square and the darkest one is almost full black, but in a properly well calibrated monitor with perfect contrast, you should be able to see all, if not most of them. If you are not able to see suppose all the first 5 squares in here, it means your monitor is not calibrated. So you need to adjust so that you can see each and every square in the black background, all right. So go ahead with that. Next will be the white saturation. In white saturation, same, it varies from gray to white. The last one is almost full white and the darkest one is gray. However, you should be able to see all of these checkerboard patterns if your monitor is properly calibrated and it has proper contrast calibration, all right. very important. And last but not the least, this is the gradient banding, and this says that the color transition should be smooth. From black to white it should be smooth, and from white to black it should be very smooth. If you see bandings, multiple bandings, it means the color toning is not proper. So adjust your monitor settings so that you are able to see a continuous smear of white to black. This is actually very easy. Please read the instructions carefully and then follow exactly what is told in the video, and that's how you can calibrate your monitor easily without buying an existing monitor with the help of this website. Bye guys.
So now that you know how to calibrate your own monitor, please calibrate it, make sure the picture looks best, and then start photo editing and start your stock photography business. The next video will be about white balance, which is another important aspect in stock photography. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing and hit the bell icon for my future uploads. As usual, please hit the thumbs up if you have liked this button and share this video to all social media, all your relatives and photographer friends, because my motive here is to build a strong community of stock photographers. So guys, thanks for watching. This is Dr. Arindam and you are watching The Teaching Doc, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.